Hi everyone, how are you today? Welcome back to my channel, Coding with Hong, where you can learn and practice coding at the same time. I just recently posted a video this week about how to code an EDI record, and I strongly suggest that you watch that video first, just to have an idea how the EDI physicians document their records. If you didn't, I'll put the link below this video. In order to reinforce what you just learned from the last lesson, I want you to read, analyze, and code an EDI record with me today. So, please pause the video and have your IC10CM book, pencil, highlight, and notepad ready. Let's roll up your sleeve and get right into it. If you want to code an EDI record effectively and completely, you have to know how to extract information from the record. And in order to do that, you must understand how the EDI physician document their records. There are three key components you would find on any EDI record. We already learned it from the last video. Let's see if you still remember what they are. If you want to be an EDI coder or the best coder, you must know this. What is the first component? I will give you 10 seconds. It is the history. If you got that right, that's great. What is the second component? I will also give you 10 seconds. Is the physical examination. And what is the third component? You also have 10 seconds. It is the medical decision making. How are you doing? If you got all of them right, that's great. You want to be the best coder. The first component is the history. And the history includes four elements: the chief complaint, the history of present illness, the review of system, the past medical, family, and social history. Your job is to review this component to find out what is the chief complaint, why they are here, what brought them to the emergency department, and if they come in because of an injury-related condition, you have to find out how that happened and where. Are you ready? Let's and analyze an EDI report with me. Working diagnosis: ankle sprain, HPI. This is the first component. The 26-year-old black female present to ED via EMS with complaint of ankle injury right. 26-year-old female present complaint of right ankle pain and swelling after tripping over her suitcase at the airport. Patient failed to ground, denied loss of consciousness or head injury. 6 alcoholic drink tonight. Denies numbness and tingling. Alright, let's see. Complain of right ankle pain and swelling. And remember, if she presents with a condition that relates to an injury, you have to find out how that happened and where. And this is show you how to happen. She tripped over her suitcase. And where? At the airport. So I highlight it. You should have a good habit of highlighting important information when you read case study for your exam, just to make sure that you don't miss anything. Alright? Historical. Allergy, no drug allergy. Homemade, patient denies. Past medical history, none. She's healthy. Social history, smoking status. Patient used tobacco product, current someday smoker. All right, some code may or may not assign the code for the tobacco products, simply because they say, well, it's not related to the presenting problem and ankle injury. For me, personally, I would like to report this code. You know why? Because some hospital or state, let's say they would like to run a report to find out how many people are smoker in, let's say, Massachusetts, and from what age to what age. This code will help them. That's why I always report the tobacco user. I'm going to highlight this so that I know I'm going to need to assign a code for that. OBGYN, the last medical period, menstrual period, May 25th, 2016. Rule out system. Again, we don't have to worry about this too much unless you are coding for a physician or professional. For the hospital coder, I skip this part. But for the purpose of this learning, I'm going to go over with you. Constitutional, negative for fever, choose, malaise. Eyes, negative for pain, redness or discharge. ENT, ear, nose and throat, negative for sinus congestion, pneumonia, short throat. Cardiovascular, negative for chest pain, palpitation or edema. Respiratory, negative for shortness of breath, cough, wheezing or pleuritic chest pain. Abdomen, GI, negative for abdominal pain, nausea, vomiting, diarrhea or constipation. GU, negative for dysuria, frequency or urgency. Musculoskeletal extremity, positive for right leg pain and swelling. Again, this is good because if you didn't know where it is, the right or the left ankle, then this help. Skin, negative for injury or rash, neuro, negative for headache, numbness and tingling. Okay, the second component is the examination. I wouldn't worry too much about this part, unless I want to know what size that, the left or the right. If I don't have information, then I might have to look under the extremity to find out. See right here, tennis right medial malleolus and first metatarsal, no swelling. It confirmed the injuries on the right ankle. The third component is the MDM, medical decision making. This is very, very important. Everything that we have read so far is all about why they are here, if they have any chronic condition or comorbidity. If that condition is injury-related condition, then we got to know how that happened and where. But so far, we don't know how they treat the patient yet. So the medical decision-making is very, very crucial. The physician will document how they treat this patient, what diagnosis that he orders, and what is his final impression or final diagnosis after study. So let's continue and see. ED course, finding, there is dorsal soft tissue swelling, no acute fracture or dislocation is seen. Yawn space are maintained. Findings, there is soft tissue swelling medially and laterally. This is good. So you don't want to use unspecified code. An osseous fragment adjacent to the talus may reflect an OS supratalar or avulsion injury. A small tibial talar joint effusion is seen. Data review, vital sign, nurse's note, radiologic study, counseling. I had a detailed discussion with the patient and all guardian regarding the historical points, exam findings, and any diagnostic result supporting the discharge diagnosis need for follow-up to return to the emergency department if symptoms worsen or persist, or if there are any questions or concerns that arise at home. My portion of the e-discharge is complete and electronically signed. Okay, here are the tests that he ordered. He ordered the ankle x-ray, a foot x-ray, the air cast and crutches, the ice pack to affect area. Attending nose, 26 years old female, right ankle pain, medial malleolus to fall. So he confirmed this again. Patient said she had history of ankle injury, able to take 5 steps. Afterward, review system denies knee pain, no numbness, no weakness, remainder review system in negative. Social history, she a travel agent. Exam alert, female in no distress, right knee, non-tender. Okay, it's confirmed again, it's on the right side. Lateral malleolus, normal right medial malleolus, pon tendons near the deltoid ligament. 3 plus DPPT pulse, no pain at the base of the fifth metatarsal. I reviewed x-ray of the right foot and right ankle, no visible fracture, so he ruled out fracture. In the emergency department, patient had finding consistent with a right ankle sprain. So this is his final impression, his final diagnosis. Now, your job is to call this record. How many diagnosis code that you would assign for this case? I would give you 10 seconds to think. There's no procedure performed in this case. If the physician applied a cast or splint to the ankle, then I would assign a CBD code, but it's not in this case. So we are good. So what you need to call? First, the ankle, right ankle sprain, then tobacco smoking. And remember, because this condition is an injury-related condition, you need to call the external cause code. How and where that happened. So how many calls total? The 4 calls total. How are you doing so far? I hope you got it right. I purposely chose this easy case for your first try since you are new. I hope that you're following more okay. Let me know if I'm going too fast or too slow. I really appreciate it. That's all for today. Thank you so much for watching. If you found this video is helpful, then please let me know by clicking the like button and make a comment so that I know you want more. Until next time, have a great day.